have travelled about 160 miles to come to this beautiful area in Cornwall. I'm on Bodmin Moor, one of the more remote moors, one of the highest pieces of land in Cornwall, in the southwest of the UK. We've just parked the car just back, and we're walking out now to find a campsite because it's quite late. It's just gone 8 o'clock in the evening, so we're going to pitch up, and then we're going to go out hiking for the next couple of days, exploring this lovely moorland. I'm out with Si and Ant. There they are in front of me. So let the adventure begin. Not sure what you can see in the gloaming, in the dark. Now set up, I'm in my tent, and I'm cooking myself some sausages on the Trangia 27. It should be a good sunrise tomorrow. My tent door's facing east, so unless anything significant happens, I should bring you back in the morning. Stones. My thought for the moment is, whilst you can do these things, you should do them, because there come a time one day when I won't be able to do them, because this is quite tricky going. It's not a walk in the park, should we say.
Ah, that's the end. You got your hand out on the end.
I've got caught on the back.
There you go. Good handle.
Careful, Ann.
Always careful.
At some point, sooner or later, this is going to go. I mean, that is going to go. I don't know which way it's going to go. I reckon it's going to topple that way, and then it's going to crash down and end up down there. Or I reckon some of the stones will go down that way, and some will go down that way. So here's Simon lighting his stove. Here's Simon trying to light his stove.
Wow, wow.
This stove is not as good as my old Trangia for lighting. No.
So what is it? Is it a Tatonk or something?
Yeah.
You didn't like it then?
Oh, it's alright, but it's just not as good as my old Trangia.
Looking back to Kilmar tour, absolutely stunning. I'll be back there one day, I'm sure. Anyway, our path now lies onwards. We're heading over to the woodland down there. Now in the distance is the whole of the tour we walked earlier, Kilmar tour, and zooming in, we started up over there. So quite a long, impressive tour.
You'll be fine.
I made it, but my camera got a bit wet.
So I'm using these. All right, my glasses back at my nose, kids. I'm using the clean canteen, they're stainless steel, 800 mil. They clearly hold the water perfectly well.
That's the right path through there, sorry.
Yeah.
Right. Just went down to his knees.
Did he?
He went down to his knees down there. That's very, very boggy, very marshy. Have you got a nice clearing? There's Simon over there filming me as I cross this narrow bridge. Rather narrow, isn't it? That is narrow. Anyway, the way is onward. Mustn't look down. Am I across yet, Si?
No,
I'm not across yet. I'm in the most vulnerable part. Over the open ground now, we're walking through logging tracks basically, but just look how dense and black the forestry is. This is a massive piece of coniferous woodland. Just walked down to a site of an old ford. That was a pathway, well, sort of a pathway behind me, but this is the area where the path forded the river. Very nice. Beautiful area. The river's not deep, but we might get wet feet. Feet wet?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to get wet feet. It's going to happen. £29 pair of boots I'm wearing. I got them from... Yeah, I got them from Decathlon. I've walked the South Downs Way, I've walked the Ridge Way in them. They're still waterproof, they're still going strong. There they are. And my feet are dry. Just about. Don't seem to have a lot of lefts left.
Sorry.
Not a lot, no.
No, I haven't got much either. I think you might have a bit more than me, but alternative fuel for you, isn't it?
I've used it with wood, and I've also used it with horse crap.
I think I saw the video.
You might have seen the video. Yeah. The video on...
Dried
horse poo.
And it worked okay, did it?
It worked very well.
And the next morning it rained?
Yes.
Well, we come off the moor now, and we're going to a pub called the Jamaica Inn. Apparently quite an old establishment, so I'm told. This is it, eh? The Smuggler's Bar. Here we are. We have ale at the Jamaica Inn. Jamaica ale. Jamaica bitter?
Ale.
Ale. Really nice. Really nice.
I'm getting down far too good.
We're on our way back now looking for somewhere to camp, but we diverted and we've come past a stone outcrop known as Carn Eglos, which translates to stone church, so Si tells me, or is commonly known as church tor. And there it is. Tree's been here because it hasn't got a very good root being on the rock there. I reckon it's been there for some time, that tree. It's obviously survived rain, winds and storm and sun. Been there for a long time. The article behind it though, I don't know.
This arsehole's been alive 44 years.
44 years. Right, we're just walking through the woods and we come across this. Now, many of you know what these are. And some of you won't, but these here fire beaters. Yeah, you as a fireman, give us a demonstration.
Right, well there are two ways to use a fire beater. One is to beat, and the other is to smother.
Very good, yeah.
Beating can actually make the fire spread if you're not careful.
Put your air down, don't you?
Yeah. Because you're, yeah, causing an air flow.
Fanning it.
So, two ways, smother or beat.
Thank you, sir.
There you go. These are horrible.
Yeah. We come across a hurdle. This is quaking bog. And the ground actually is moving, so, isn't it?
Yeah.
You feel the whole ground moving.
We're literally on moss, which is above water.
Oh shit, I can feel the whole thing bouncing in.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah.
So this could be anything from a few inches deep to, well, very deep.
Yeah. But we've got to go across, haven't we?
We have got to get across there somehow. And the fog is...
It's not...
Well, it's a tree, at least.
I'm not seeking through it.
No, you're not, but that's not the point, is it?
Well, I'm out of it. I'm on solid ground now. Sai's stuck in it still, but he's making his way through. Ant's on the edge of it. It wasn't that bad. But we're now going to make our way back to the old farmhouse and pitch up camp in one of the paddocks. Camped up, and I've got a nice steak to eat tonight, and I've also been given a bottle of small bottle, single malt, from my friend Lorraine. So I'm gonna. I said I'd drink it on a special occasion, so this is it. I'm looking forward to that. So I'll have that after I've had my steak. So thanks to Lorraine for that, and I'm not sharing it. It's all mine.
You carry on. I've got Jack Daniels and Coke.
Have you? Oh!
In a can?
Share it then. Got to strike camp soon, but it's so damp. It was a still night last night. Condensation's really bad. Really bad. Misty out there.
What's on with these bloody crane flies? Them bloody everywhere. Them all over the bloody shop here. Like them. Oh, more than that.
Done. So,
from Sai it is.
Bye for now. We'll be right back.